Yankees and Rebels this time, but one united people that stand behind America.
Jason with the forever This is Jason with the forever free gunner.
And this is John with Montana John's Outdoor Adventures. And Jason and I were driving down the road and we got into a covey of these are spruce grouse. So I got two right here. Jason has three. I'll grab one for you. See, so you can see all three of his.
Yeah.
Two. Three. There you go. He's got three. So, these are spruce grouse. Hey, remember, subscribe, like, and click that bell for notifications for both of our channels, Forever Free Gunner and Montana John's Outdoor Adventures.
And I use the 17 HMR, guys. Probably a little much for the sage grouse, especially if you don't hit them directly in the head when they're moving like they were for us. So, I'll have some footage on here of the 4K, and I'll let John have some of it too, so you guys can see it all in 4K from the scope cam, guys.
I use the Ruger bull barrel 1022. In Montana, you could use a rifle or a pistol to hunt grouse, and they run up through the timber, and as you can see the timber behind us, they run through it, they'll get up on a log, and you can just shoot them right in the head. So these are all headshots that I got. Jason got one body shot on and kind of, you know, just chewed it up a little bit.
Yeah, my rifle zeroed for 50 yards, and they were only maybe 10 yards away, so I caught them a little lower than I would normally like. You guys will see that in the footage. I'm not going to hide anything. The meat's still good, and then also John uses them for his traps, so nothing's going to waste here, period. So
the lower end of the bird, and what I'll do is I'll save all this, and I will use... I take the breast out. Well, we're going to show you how to breast these out on video. And the leftover, I'll use the wing for bobcat trapping, like Roland down there in Kentucky. Roland! Look at that, buddy. Got some grouse for dinner. And Mike over there in Missouri from Way to Go Kennels. Those guys, you got to check those channels out. Check out Roland, the MBA, Mountain Bushcraft for Alliance. And check out Way to Go Kennels. Awesome channels, guys. Awesome channels. But check out, we got some really nice birds. And like I said, we shot them at the 22 and we're gonna breast them out right now.
Right, yep. And guys, if you have children or anything watching that are sensitive to blood, or if you're sensitive to blood, you're not gonna wanna watch this, because you're gonna be seeing guts come out of an animal. We will go ahead in the beginning of the video and put a warning on both of our channels that it is graphic. But guys, this is part of being a Montanan. I'd also like to give a shout out to Bear Independent. I really like his channel. I'm not friends with him yet, but hopefully he'll see me giving a shout out to his channel. Really like him, guys, for survival information, homesteading information. I'm going to start getting a little more into that, guys. So we're going to go ahead and breast these out for you guys.
One quick thing I want to say. The nice thing about the bull barrel 1022, or just a 1022, semi-automatic. In Montana, you can get into a covey of 10 birds sometimes. And we got into a covey of 5.
And we got them all.
We got them all. Yeah. And there could be more. We just didn't see them.
Yeah.
But the semi-automatic, the nice thing about it is you can just continue to shoot and, you know, you can really do really well with it. That's all.
And like I said, the 17 is a little much for grouse. It really is. It's just what I had set up with the camera on it right now. Actually, it would have been better if I'd taken the
put the other camera on the 22 now that I think about it, the Western Tacticam.
Sorry about the F-bomb, guys. Sorry about the F-bomb.
That's right. Well, we're going to brush these out now. Yeah. All right, I want to show you guys what a spruce grouse has. It has a red slash over its eye. See the red slash? That's how you know what a spruce grouse is. See? They have a little red slash over their eye. So, and their tails almost look like a blue grouse.
Mm-hmm.
Almost. There's a tail. So they almost look like a blue grouse.
Yep. So guys, what we're doing is we're just breasting it out, and this is the technique that they've been using for hundreds of years.
So you put your feet over the wings like this.
Yep.
Breast up so the you can see that in my video.
Yep. Perfect.
Okay.
Yep.
So let me get this out of your way so you can see. The breast is up, you're stepping on both wings. Now you're gonna grab the feet. And you grab the feet and you pull up slow. And you wanna do this when it's warm. And now, as I pull this up, I just left the breast, and I leave that attached still, and I'm gonna pull this apart
Go ahead.
I'm gonna do another one, so we'll be good.
That's fine.
Okay, I'm gonna pull this apart now. This is
You're out of yours too.
Okay. This is all the waist. So now we have the breast. I'm gonna show both cameras, see the breast? Yeah. And look how perfect, it's gutted, perfect.
Yep.
Can you see that?
Yep.
Okay, see on this one here, there's the back. Okay.
And guys, believe it or not, you can do this with a turkey.
A wild turkey,
you can do the same thing because you don't usually, wild meat, you don't usually eat the legs and stuff.
Right.
I mean, I'm not saying that you can't.
Now in Montana, you have to leave one wing on.
Yep, it's for so that if fish and game stops you, they can sex the bird by
identification.
By the wing, yep.
Yep, they know that's they can tell identification if it's a blue grouse, spruce grouse, ruffle grouse. Yeah. So
And the regulations in Montana for us, it's all the same. We can have three a day, per person, per species.
Can you see me in that camera?
Yeah. Here? But so if we were to see a different kind of grouse, we wouldn't really be, we can only just have three a day. We can't shoot another kind of grouse now. I'm limited out. John can shoot one more.
Yeah, as long as you just shoot three grouse of any species, it doesn't matter. Except for sharp-tailed grouse and stuff, they don't count as these. But, so now I save these super one sack to go grocery shopping with. I put them in there. So now we're going to do, this here, I'm going to save all this. And I'll hang this in my bobcat trap. So I'm gonna put this in a bag and save that. So now we're gonna do another one. Can you see me in my camera or no?
No, I'm gonna bring it down a little bit. And then when you skin it down there, just do the skinning and everything.
Okay. Oh, I know what I'm gonna do real quick. I just want to tell you on this bird here, they have a red slash over their eye, which I already said, kind of like a cutthroat trout.
Right.
And also, on a spruce grouse, they'll have little white tips on their tails, and they almost look like a blue grouse, but I can tell right away that these are not blue grouse before I shot them, because I saw the red slash over their eye. So, all right, let's get these back in position here.
Okay, yep, so you're in position.
Okay, can you see it in yours?
Yep.
Okay, I'm gonna put my feet over the wings, right up against the body, and now I'm gonna pull up. Is my recording though?
Yeah.
Is it, it's going, the timer's counting down?
Yeah.
Okay, I just wanna make sure I didn't miss it. Okay, now and you wanna do these when they're warm.
And don't jerk. Don't jerk up. Slowly pull up, just like John's doing. I'm just gonna separate everything out.
There we go. That's perfect. Whoops. Oh, I should stay down low.
Yeah, stay down low. You're fine.
Okay, and now the back part. Sometimes if it doesn't come out, the back part, I just pull it up and over. But everything came out nice. I mean, we breasted that, the whole bottom. There's no meat on the legs.
Yeah, not enough for eating. It's good for trapping,
Right. So what I do is, look at all, I'm going to show you what they've been eating. We'll show them all what they've been eating here. Now, how did I know these are spruce grouse? Look how dark red that meat is. Can you see that in the video?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's how you can tell.
Looks like a heart.
Yes, they're very deep red. Now, a blue grouse would be white.
White.
Like clear, clear, like chicken. It would be just like chicken. So these are spruce grouse. You want to see how little the heart is? Look how little the heart is. Can you see that?
Oh yeah.
In the video?
Beautiful. Yep.
I know, isn't that? That's amazing. That's what keeps the bird alive, basically. That's its like energy.
And these things survive through harsh winters. They are amazing little critters, guys. And you know, thank the Lord for our ability to hunt and to feed ourselves off the land here in Montana. I'm very grateful for everything that's given to me. So it's not just given, obviously we hunted them, but the land gave it to us too. So
I want to show you what they were eating. I got some in their crop here.
Yeah.
And they were eating a whole bunch of pine needles.
Ooh, pine needles.
Yeah, nice. That's why they call them spruce grouse, because they eat the needles. Look at those needles.
Straight up, all just needles. Oh yeah, beautiful.
Okay, good. They like this particular needle, and they just devour those needles. Look how many needles are in there. Whoa, they're sharp, Jason. Feel how sharp they are.
Oh yeah, they're jet. Yeah, these hurt. They get in your socks.
Yeah,
and stuff.
That's why they're from spruce trees.
Yeah,
that's why they call them a spruce grouse.
That's cool.
They eat a lot of spruce needles.
So our channels aren't just—we're not just glorifying killing the animal. These animals are getting eaten. We're giving due respect to them, and then we're educating you guys. We're showing you this is not to, you know, be gross or graphic. This is to show you, and then show them their
gizzard.
The gizzard.
This is a grouse gizzard.
Yeah. In fact, that's bigger than their stomach by volume. So that's what grinds up all their stuff. They actually eat rocks off the road.
And that's what they do when we drive around in Montana. We look for grouse on the road.
Yep.
So the grouse come out to the road, and when they come out to the road, they're picking grit and gravel so they can grind up all their food in here.
Their stomach doesn't digest food like ours does. It processes it differently.
Can you believe that?
Yeah, it gets ground up inside there.
That's intense, isn't it? How much is in there?
That's crazy. Well, it's like the prairie dogs. All the prairie dogs, stuffed full of the grass seed and stuff.
Yeah.
You'll never realize how voracious.
Let's see what this one has.
Probably the same
thing. Oh, yeah. Oh, this has kinny kinnick berries in it. Look at this.
Ooh.
So this has the red berries in it. Look at that. Yeah. See the red berries?
Yeah.
Can you see them in the video?
Yep.
I want people to see
this. Yeah, perfect. And guys, you wouldn't want to eat those berries. They're called pithy. They're like a dry apple. They're not very good at all.
Yeah.
For eating.
Oh, these aren't.
But the birds love them.
I thought they were kinnikinicks, but they're not.
No, these are.
They're not kinnikinicks because the Indians would eat for.
No, if you bust this open, see, it's very pithy in there. See.
Look at
not delicious to eat. It's got a lot of seeds in it.
These spruce needles are they're like needles.
Little daggers.
They're like daggers. And I think that's why they get their name. I'm not 100% sure, but I think that's why they get their name spruce grouse, because they eat a lot of spruce needles and they stay around the spruce trees. But I will take this rolling down there in Kentucky, and Mike down there in Missouri, you guys are big bobcat trappers. Well, I'm going to trap bobcat with this. I'm going to hang this right in my, I'll hang this in my cubby. So none of this, like we said, will go to waste.
Not a single bit of it.
Yeah. So
it'll get used.
And I take this here and I'll hang this on a tree, on a piece of fishing line, and it just dangles in the wind like this. And that's what attracts the bobcats. Can you see that, Jason, of yours? Good. So this here, I hang in front of my snare, and this will bring the bobcats in. And then they'll see this, and they smell it, and they think they're taking another animal's catch.
So guys, this is Jason with the Forever Free Gunner. We just wanted to bring you along with us. This is what we do this time of year. We're about to do a salmon snagging video. We're going to have some really good HD footage of a snagging hole that we go to. We got a whole week planned of that, guys. We're going to bring you along with us. So I just want to thank you for watching the Forever Free Gunner. God bless, and keep your powder dry.
And I got 1,000 subscribers now. Thank you to everyone who subscribed for that. Thank you. So like, subscribe, and click that bell for notifications. And I just got, like I said, I just got 1,000 subscribers, and I can go live pretty soon here. And if my live is up and running, I'm going to try and get to do some live salmon snagging where we're going to be.
Yeah, we're... We're gonna be bringing you guys a lot of live stuff. I'm not yet at 1,000, so please help me get there, guys.
He's a good. Hey, check his channel out, Forever Free Gunner. Check it out, guys.
I do a lot of gunsmithing and stuff, and then we're gonna be, now that John and I are friends, we've been friends coming up on a year now, I think.
Getting close to a year, yeah.
So you know, we're gonna start doing some more collaborations since we live in the same town, and just bring you guys some awesome content. John's got some awesome content.
Jason has awesome content.
So guys, again, we just want to thank you very much. We appreciate it. We actually do this not for ourselves. We do this for you guys so that we can teach you. I buy lots and lots of guns, so you guys don't have to go out and buy them. You can see how I use them and if they work. And then you guys can kind of make an educated decision rather than just making a, you know, off the cuff purchase.
Right,
you
know. Right. And we have a lot together with his channel and my channel together. I do educational videos. He does educational videos. He does how to repair guns. I show you how to repair certain guns or fix guns. We both have cool channels combined. So if you watch them both, you'll get a little bit of knowledge from each of us and we'll make you whole.
Right.
You know?
Right. So yeah, we just want to thank you guys. It's just, we want to share Montana with people too. You know, the world seems like it's getting a lot more closed off, and things like YouTube, we're allowed to share our world with you, and I think that's really cool.
Right.
To be able to share Montana. Montana is, besides my wife and my daughter, is the love of my life. Montana is me. I mean, I got a tattoo on my forearm of Montana, guys. I love Montana. So, and I also have, of course, we can't forget our ammunition company together, Dead Lead Ammunition, guys. By the end of next year, we will be selling ammo. So
hopefully, yeah, we should have it all set up and rolling.
Hopefully, we're gonna be selling ammo. Custom shotgun shells and 9mm to begin with, and then we'll branch out from there.
Oh yeah. All right. Thank you for watching. Thank you to all the men and women who serve our country, and God bless America.
Slow it way down in the woods or right up town. I'm a country boy, got a four-wheel drive. Climb in my bed, I'll take you for a ride up city streets.
You'll be sorry that you mess with the U.S. of A. 'Cause we'll put a boot in your ass, it's in America.